If you're an accountant using Excel, the absolute best tool at your disposal is an XLookup. I'm Kyle with the Technical Accountant, and today we're going to cover three exact scenarios when you want to use an XLookup. We'll go into a detailed discussion on how to create an XLookup formula, with the goal being that when you leave this video, you know how to put it to work, and you also have access to the downloadable spreadsheet and the links below with the formulas, with the examples that we're going to cover today. Let's get to it. So to set the stage here, I've got an Excel sheet with three different tabs: my customers, the customer addresses, and all of the receivables transactions for those customers. The first example here, one of the best, most simple examples with XLookups, is you can combine two different sets of data. So in this situation, I've got all my receivables, and again, I've got all my customers back here on the first tab. Well, all my receivables, I'm looking at my receivables and I don't have a customer name. That information wasn't given to me. So what I can do is with an XLookup, I could say, well, let's go find the customer number from the customers tab, and then let's pull over the customer name. So to do that, XLookup, and as you pull this up, just tab through and it'll kind of tell you, what you're clicking through here. So your lookup value, what do I want to go find in my other tab? Well, I want to go find Pulaski 0001. My lookup array, where do I want to go find Pulaski? Well, that would be my customer spreadsheet. That's just going to be somewhere in this column, column A, comma, what do I want to return? Well, in this situation, I want to return column B, comma, what I wanted to say if it's not found. I could leave it blank, or I could just, spell it out. Customer does not exist. Match mode. In this situation, I'm looking for an exact match. If I was looking for, something close to, but didn't have to be exact, I could use wildcards, something other, but today it's exact match. So just tabbing through here, hitting zero, comma. And last bit here says, what is my search mode? Search mode is actually an optional field here. I'm actually just going to skip it all together. We'll get into that here in a second though. So anyways, there we go. So I pulled over Pulaski Enterprises, and now I can drop this list all the way down, and then all of a sudden for my receivables transactions, I have the customer name. Next example here, I have my customer listing. I want to go find the last invoice date for each customer. So again, perfect example for an XLookup. So let's go XLookup. What I want to go find? Well, let's go find Aaron Fitt. Where do I want to find it? I want to go find him over here on the receivables transaction listing in column A. Aaron Fitt's going to be in column A, comma. What do I want to return? Well, in this situation, again, I'm looking for the last invoice number, date. If not found, in this situation, I'm just going to leave it blank. Match mode, in this situation, I'm looking exactly for the customer number to match. So I'm using zero. We don't want anything close to, it's gotta be the exact match. And the next prompt here is a search mode. This is where it's gonna matter a lot, which option we go with here. So I can see that my receivables transactions are sorted from oldest to newest. So oldest at the top, newest at the bottom. You see we go all the way down to 2027, 2028. So in this situation, I'm looking for the last record in this list per customer. If I did first to last, it's going to say, okay, well, let's go find the first match of Pulaski and let's pull the corresponding document or document date. But in this situation, I'm saying let's pull last to first. So it goes all the way from the bottom, and the first time it finds Pulaski, it will pull in the document date. So there's my last invoice date for Aaron Fitt here. Again, drop that down. There's my listing for all of my customers. Another great option with XLookup, especially for those of you familiar with the VLookup, is with XLookup, I can compare on multiple fields and find the result. Example being, on my receivables listing here, I've got my customer number and I've got the address code. I don't have any sort of date. Well, if I go look at my customer addresses, you know, those are the two fields that I have to look up against in order to pull the address one field. I can't just look up against customer number. I can't just look up against address code because you see there's multiples here. So I need to find the specific combination of the both in order to pull the address one. So to do that, XLookup, and this time I'm going to say, well, I want to go find Pulaski and I want to go find the combination of Pulaski and the address code primary. All right. And then it says, well, where do I want to go find these at? So let's go to my customer addresses. Well, the first one is going to come. That was the customer number. So I'm going to go find A2 somewhere in the A column. Let's do and again, and then I'm going to go find H2, which was the address code over here in the B column, comma, and it says return array. What do I want to return? I want to return address one. If not found, we're going to blank it out. Match mode, going for an exact match. I'm going to skip the sorting first to last. So you see here, it found the match of both Pulaski and primary, and it gave me my address one match. Now, final example on the flip side, again, with VLOOKUP, I can only return one column. In this situation with XLOOKUP, you can return multiple columns. So I'm gonna go find Pulaski again here for the third or fourth time. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna return two separate columns. See what that means. We're going to pull back the sales region and the salesperson for Pulaski. So equals XLOOKUP, my lookup value. I just want to find Pulaski. Let's go to customers. I want to find Pulaski in column A. Now it's saying return. Well, I want to return the sales territory and I'm going to add a separator in here. Pipe, and I'm also going to return column F. And again, value if not found, we're going to leave it blank. And we're looking for an exact match of Pulaski. So you see it's returning territory for and Sandra M from the salesperson. Drop it down, and now we have all of our sales reasons and salesperson combinations for all of our customers. So that is XLOOKUPs. Hopefully you've seen enough to understand kind of how the formula works, but more importantly, you've seen how useful this tool can be and really how simple this tool is and how frequent you can use it. Again, this spreadsheet will be available for download in the comments below. Highly suggest you take a look at it. That way you have working formulas, you have working examples, you can work back on this video if you'd like to. My name is Kyle with The Technical Accountant. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe. If you have ideas, if there's other things that you're looking to learn more about, please let me know in the comments below and also check out thetechnicalaccountant.com. See you next time.